Well, Ted, I've only got one more question for you, and that has to do with something that you wrote in your editor's intro for the section, which is both on the hardcover edition and also online. You talked about how the media and subsequent broadcasting of Appalachian music tended to change Appalachian music a bit from its original intent, I suppose. And I wanted to know if you see this new digital age or the online age taking Appalachian music in new directions, and how we can also keep some of those traditional influences intact.
Yeah, media's had a strong role in the dissemination of Appalachian music dating back to the 19th century with songbooks and touring groups that performed on live stages promoted by the local media. Into the 20th century with the rise of the phonograph, record, and radio and television. Media's always had an important role in the story of Appalachian music and has changed the music over the years accordingly. So with the online access, the ease of access of music online and the ease of dissemination of information about this music online, sure, I mean, the online encyclopedia of Appalachian music section has the potential of making the story of Appalachian music much more familiar and accessible to more and more people of newer generations who are being, in some cases, exposed to Appalachian music in all its variety for the first time through the medium of the online encyclopedia. And these folk, shall we say, are getting the full story, or at least what we hope is the nearly full story. We're certainly trying for it to be the full story of Appalachian music in the music section. So students are finding out that Appalachian music is incredibly diverse, involves different ethnic and racial groups and different people of different backgrounds, socioeconomically speaking, different gender groups involved with music making through the years. All these stories are being disseminated at once to the interested student who uses the online music section, and so that therefore when they think of Appalachian music in the future, it's likely that they're going to think more holistically and more comprehensively about what Appalachian music is. I think it has the potential of changing certain notions about what Appalachian music is in the wider culture. Certain more kind of stereotype notions of what Appalachian music is just won't hold up with the new knowledge that Appalachian music is really a lot more, it's about a lot more than any one particular representation. You know, some people in the past might have thought Appalachian music is, shall we say, mostly about, you know, rural music from a certain part of Appalachia. Well, that's certainly an important part of the story of Appalachian music, no doubt about it. And, you know, we've certainly tried to represent that aspect of Appalachian music in the online music section. But there are urban forms of music, there are forms of music in Appalachia that most people have never really associated with the region, but have always been within the region, or at least in recent years have been long been in the region. Therefore, it diversifies the story. It provides more context and more, shall we say, a sense of Appalachian music being ever-changing, ever-growing, and that could only be a good thing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that just about wraps up our webcast here on the Appalachian Music section online. Ted, thanks again for being here.
Thanks, Thomas.
If you're interested in discovering all that the Appalachian Music section online has to offer, please go to encyclopediaofappalachia.com. Thanks for watching.